Hello children, in today's class we are going to discuss about laboratory thermometer. In the previous class we have discussed about clinical thermometer, where we will use that to measure only the temperature of a human body, and you cannot measure any other measure the temperature of any such objects because it may intend to break. So that is the reason we use clinical thermometer only on a human body. And if you look at the laboratory thermometer, we can measure the temperature of other objects apart from the human body. And there are many different types of thermometer available for various purposes. So if you look at the maximum and minimum temperature of the previous day reported in weather reports, it will be measured by a thermometer called the maximum and minimum thermometer. In our school prayer also, you would have read about the weather reports on daily basis, right? So if you look at the weather reports, how do you think they will predict exactly the maximum temperature and the minimum temperature on a particular day with the help of the thermometer called the maximum minimum thermometer? Understood? And this laboratory thermometer ranges from minus 10 degrees Celsius to 110 degrees Celsius. But what about a clinical thermometer, which we have discussed already? It ranges from 35 degrees Celsius to 42 degrees Celsius, because below 35 degree or above 42 degrees Celsius, a human body temperature will not exceed or it will not reduce. So that is the reason it has been set in that range. Whereas in a laboratory thermometer, a particular object may go below the 0 degrees Celsius or it may go beyond 100 degrees Celsius. So if you take a boiling point of water, it may boil up to even 110 degrees Celsius. And if you take a chill ice cube, its temperature may go below 0 degrees Celsius. Now you understood. So that is the reason a laboratory thermometer ranges from minus 10 degrees Celsius to 110 degrees Celsius. And you have to make a note of the highest and the lowest temperature in a laboratory thermometer that it can measure. See here, this is how a laboratory thermometer will look like. And it is not like a normal clinical thermometer. It is little bit of length. And to perform an activity based on this laboratory thermometer, see here, you have to take some tap water in a beaker or in a mug, and after taking the water, just dip this thermometer in that water and make sure the bulb immersed in the water should not touch the bottom of the mug, or even it should not touch the sides of the mug. So it you have to just dip in that water alone. Make sure it does not touch the bottom or the sides of the container. Clear? And hold the hold the thermometer vertically, like they have shown in the picture. So once you hold it vertically and observe the movement of mercury inside the thermometer. So if you observe the movement of the mercury, it will start to rise or it will start to fall down based on the cooling temperature or the boiling point temperature of the water. So you have to wait till the mercury thread becomes steady. So once it becomes steady, you have to make a note of the reading of the thermometer. So once you observe the reading, compare the temperature of water recorded by other students in the class. So if you compare and notice, there may be some variations in the readings, and discuss all the possible reasons regarding the variations of the temperature which has been recorded from the water. Clear? So if you discuss the possible reasons, one might be because of the cooling, because of the chillness of the water, and one might be because of the hotness of the water. So it depends based on the water which you use for measuring the temperature of it. And there are many concerns over the use of mercury in thermometers. So mercury is a kind of a toxic substance, that is, it is very poisonous and it is very dangerous to handle in case if the thermometer breaks out. So you have to use the thermometer with care. Clear? And the reason, have you ever wondered that why does the mercury not fall or rise in a clinical thermometer? Have you ever noticed once you taken out of the mouth, it will remain steady and it will not fall or it will not even rise beyond except the exact temperature of your body? So the reason behind that is the kink near the bulb. Because by using the bulb, you will keep it under your tongue to measure the temperature. But near that bulb, you will have a material called kink. So the use of Kinkers, it prevents mercury level from falling on its owner. See, if you look at this picture, this is how a kink will be. Can you see here? This is how the kink will be. So this kink prevents the mercury from falling on its own till the bulb of the mercury once the body temperature has been noted. So that is the reason why the mercury will not fall or it will not rise in a clinical thermometer. And mercury, I have told you, which is a very toxic substance and it is very difficult to dispose of if a thermometer breaks. So nowadays we get even the digital thermometers which are available in the medical shops also, so that does not use mercury. So it is very easy to handle and to analyze the temperature of a human body. I hope you understood the difference between the clinical thermometer and a laboratory thermometer. So clinical thermometer you can use only on the human body, and a laboratory thermometer you can use on any other objects to check the exact temperature of the objects. Thank you, children.